In this Cricut tutorial for beginners, we are transforming an acrylic blank into a super cute and personalized Christmas tree ornament. And in the process, I'm going to show you what, in my opinion, is the best hack for actually layering permanent adhesive vinyl. So let's get crafty. Hey, I'm Michael, and this is Mr. Crafty Pants, your Cricut and crafting channel, where I post Cricut tips, tricks, and tutorials every single week. So if you are new around here and you're just trying to figure out your Cricut cutting machine, well, you may want to consider stamping that subscribe button and then ringing that little bell for all of the notifications, because you do not want to miss out on a single Cricut minute, especially during the month of December, because y'all, today is December 1st and we are kicking off our 12 days of Craftmas. I am so excited for this. This is a 12-part video series where not only are you gonna get 12 holiday or Christmas themed Cricut projects, but you're also getting 12 chances to win a humongous Cricut prize package. And this prize package, y'all, it's nothing to joke around with. I am giving away a Cricut Maker, and I'm also giving away a Cricut Joy. So whoever the winner is can then actually gift that to someone else in their life and just pay it forward and spread the love, because we all know that 2020 needs all the love that it can get. I am also throwing in a 30-foot roll of my favorite transfer tape, as well as every single color of the StarCraft HD permanent adhesive vinyl. I'll also throw in a pin weeding tool and a few other little goodies as well. Now let's get you registered to win this prize package. So inside of each of these 12 Craftmas videos that's premiering on my channel this month, there is a hidden holiday or Christmas themed phrase. What you need to do is actually watch these videos from the very beginning all the way up until the very end, because throughout the course of the video, one word out of that phrase will be popping up on the screen one at a time. What you need to do is just jot those words down whenever you see them, and if you get them all at the very end of this video, you will have a complete holiday or Christmas themed phrase. What you then need to do is just text me that phrase. Text it to me at 502-878-7189. If you're not a part of my texting community already, you'll just need to go through some prompts to actually join my texting community. But as long as that phrase is complete and correct, then you are registered to win this prize package. And this will be running all the way up until Christmas Day. Now, I am fully aware that a lot of you all outside of the United States have some problems trying to join that texting community. And I obviously do not want to leave anyone out. For those and only those who live outside of the United States, you can actually email me your completed phrase. So email it to me at mcpgiveaways@gmail.com. All right, so now let's dive into today's project, which I am so excited for, because we are diving into one small part of the 143 vinyl mystery box. Y'all, this was a huge, huge hit. These went live on Black Friday, and fingers crossed you all got one. If you didn't get one, you can still pick up a lot of these same materials on 143vinyl.com. The link to all of it will be down in that description box below for you guys. But for those who did get this, then we are going to have some fun today, because again, I'm only covering one small piece of the mystery box, but it's still going to be so much fun to do. So I am actually using this little acrylic ornament right here. Now, right now it looks solid white, but don't let that fool you. That is just a protective film that's protecting the acrylic itself. We will peel that off whenever it comes time to actually customizing it. And to customize it, I am going to be using some of the Caesar pressure sensitive vinyl, also known as Caesar PSV. Now, this is not a heat transfer vinyl. This is a permanent adhesive vinyl, similar to Orcal 651 or StarCraft HD. And the colors that I'm using in the Caesar PSV is the flame red right here. Now, this is one of the glitter vinyls in their collection, as well as this glittering gold color right here, which is also absolutely stunning. And the camera is just not doing this any justice, because y'all, these are stunning in real life. I will also be using the StyleTech Ultra Glitter in the color Emerald. Now, this stuff is amazing, and y'all are just gonna have to trust me that this is not reading anywhere on camera the same that it does in real life. Like, this is beautiful. I am also going to be stepping outside of my comfort zone. Y'all know I love the medium tech transfer tape from 143 Vinyl. However, I did get some Caesar transfer tape inside this mystery box as well, so I figured, what the heck? Why not? Let's go ahead and try this out for today's project as well. This is the Caesar transfer tape. And obviously we are going to be using my favorite way to actually go about layering a permanent adhesive vinyl. And I typically use parchment paper. However, I am out of parchment paper. I've been using it so much here lately. So I'm actually going to be using this wax paper right here instead, because wax paper will also do the job. And last but not least, we are also going to need an SVG cut file. And this is the one that I'm using right here from designbundles.net. This was a part of their ultimate $1 sale. This was just an absolutely insane sale where they had 15,000 items. Actually, I think the sale is still going on by the time that this video airs. I think the sale is still going on. So 15,000 items at $1 a piece. You might want to go ahead and jump on that sale. I will leave a link for that down in that description box below as well. All right, so now let's go ahead and jump over to Cricut Design Space and we'll get started on this project. And as you can see right here, I have already downloaded that SVG file from designbundles.net and uploaded that into Cricut Design Space. Now, if you are new to the Cricut world and you're not entirely sure how to go about doing that, don't worry about that whatsoever. I actually created a step-by-step video that walks you through the entire process, and I will link that for you right up here, as well as down in that description box below. But as far as this SVG file right here, let's first take a look over here at the right-hand side of the page where this layers panel is. And we can see that it's kind of, it's sectioned out into different groupings. So what I actually wanna do first is make sure that this is all selected. And then right up here, right above the layers panel, I'm gonna select ungroup, just like that. And as you can see right here, here's another grouping. I'm gonna do the same thing with that and ungroup that. Let's take a look at this real quick. Here is part of the wreath. I'm gonna hold down the shift key and actually select this other part of the wreath. And I'm actually gonna come down here towards the bottom right-hand corner, and we are going to select attach, just like so. And the reason we want to actually attach them instead of just leaving them grouped like they were is because we want them to actually cut out onto our vinyl exactly the way that we're seeing them right here on our canvas. All right, so now let's come over here where it says the family. So I'm gonna select this, and then holding down my shift key, I'm also gonna select the. And since it looks like some of these are overlapping, instead of actually attaching these, I'm actually gonna come down here and select weld instead. All right, so now you may also notice that there is obviously a piece of this SVG file that's missing, and that is the family's name. So I'm actually gonna fix that by coming over here to the left-hand side of the page and selecting text, and I'm just gonna type in here Peterson. There we go. Now I'm not too keen on that font, so what I'm actually gonna do is come up here towards the top left-hand corner, select where it says font, then I'm gonna come right over here where it says system. And system is basically all of the fonts that you own and that are permanently downloaded onto your computer. And so I'm gonna do a search on here real quick for Honey. And this is the font right here that I was looking for. It's actually called Hello Honey. And I also got this from the Design Bundles Ultimate $1 sale event. I will also have a link to this down in that description box below as well. I'm gonna select that. And as you can see, I went ahead and changed our text right here on our canvas. All right, so I'm actually gonna go ahead and click this little resize handle right here at the bottom right-hand corner of our text, and then just drag that outwards. And here is one of my own personal pet peeves whenever there is spacing between each of these letters. So what I'm actually gonna do is come over here to the top right-hand corner of the canvas and select ungroup. And by doing that, we can actually move each of these letters anywhere we want on the canvas. But I'm actually gonna scoot that a little bit closer to that P. I'm actually gonna have that E going into the T right there. Move this E closer. This R, I'm actually gonna have attached to that E. We'll move this S in closer as well. I'm actually gonna have that S going into that O, and then that O going into that N, like so. There we go. All right, so now I'm actually gonna click and drag over all these letters. And since they are overlapping, we don't want to attach, we want to actually weld instead. So I'm gonna come down here towards the bottom right-hand corner and select weld. So now while that's actually selected, I'm gonna hold down my shift key and select that layer that says the family. And then I'm gonna come down here towards the bottom right-hand corner and select attach. And now that is all one solid layer. And I actually want this to cut out in a different color. So I'm actually gonna have this cut out in that glittering gold color, which I think will be super pretty. So I'm gonna come up here towards the top left-hand corner and signify that by selecting this little color swatch. And this little kind of a peachy color right here will do for now as like the gold, so to speak. And the reason why we want to have multiple colors for this specifically is because anything that is the same exact color, Cricut is going to automatically try to cut that out onto the same cutting mat. Well, we don't necessarily want that. We actually want to have three different cutting mats with a different color on each of those. Now, we already have three colors here, so we don't really need to worry about changing the black to a green. However, if you want to, just for the sake of getting a visual of how it's going to actually look once it's all said and done, we could select that and then come up here towards the top left-hand corner again, and then just change that to that green color. All right, so now all we need to do is just resize this to fit onto our ornament. So I'm actually going to create a template first to represent our ornament. And for that template, I'm going to come over here to the left-hand side of the page, click on shapes, and I'm going to open up this circle. Now I've already measured out this ornament and it is 3 inches round exactly. So what I'm actually going to do is resize the circle to be exactly 3 inches around, so we know exactly what size to make our design here. So I'm going to come up here towards the top of the canvas, and it's pretty close to 3 already, but we can go ahead and just change out the numbers next to width, enter in a 3, hit enter. And since that little padlock is locked, it kept the same proportions for the height as well. So I went ahead and changed the height to be 3 inches as well. All right, so now what we need to do is just click and drag over our wreath and all of our design here, and then click this little recess handle right here at the bottom right hand corner, drag that inwards. We may need to actually right click our shape here, our circle, and then select send it back. And we actually need to shrink this down a little bit further, just until it's at the point of actually looking okay on our surface. All right, so as we can see here, these little lines are kind of extending out past our circle. So one thing that we can actually do to fix that is just by slicing off these little ends of the line. So to do that, what I'm actually gonna have to do is come over here, select this little wreath where we did attach it. Instead of having it attached, let's just go ahead and change that to weld, make that one solid image. So with it being welded now, I can now hold down my shift key and then come down here and select the circle, and then come down here towards the bottom right hand corner and select slice. We can go ahead and just move all this out of the way. And here on this layer right here, we can see where this is the little end of those lines that I wanted to get rid of. So let's go ahead and click this little X up here at the top left-hand corner. Then we can go ahead and just click and drag over the circle as well as all the other little remnants from the slice, and then come up here towards the top left-hand corner of this image and select that little X, and now it's all gone. All right, so now let's come up here towards the top right-hand corner and select make it. All right, so this is all just showing us how it's going to cut out onto our cutting mat. So I'm actually going to come down here towards the bottom right-hand corner and select continue. All right, so even though we are using two different types of vinyl today, the Caesar Glitter PSV, as well as the StyleTech Ultra Glitter, we are still going to be using the same exact cut setting on both. And that cut setting is glitter vinyl with more pressure. So to find that, I'm actually just going to come right over here and select browse all materials. And if you are using a Cricut Explore device, just turn your dial over to custom, and then this page right here should pop up for you. But I'm going to select browse all materials and then just do a search for glitter and select glitter vinyl right here, and then select done. And then right here for the pressure, I'm actually going to change that from default to more. Now all we need to do is just load our cutting mats and get started cutting. And it should be no surprise by now, but to weed all this out, I am going to be using my pin weeding tool right here. All right, so now I'm just going to cut off a piece of this transfer tape. So I'm actually just going to lay this down, grab my scissors, and then just trim out around this. All right, so now I'm just gonna take my transfer tape and apply it down right over top of this vinyl. All right, so now I'm just gonna flip over our decal and then peel the backing paper off of our vinyl and transfer tape. And now I'm just gonna grab a little piece of wax paper. Now I normally use parchment paper for this, but since I'm out, wax paper will do the job as well. I'm actually just gonna apply this right over top of the transfer tape, like on the sticky side. All right, so now I'm gonna grab our ornament here. And again, it looks white, but that's only because of that film right over top of the ornament itself. So I'm just gonna kind of pick at a corner until I can get that film to lift up. All right, so now I'm gonna reposition my decal onto the wax paper, where just a little bit of the decal is popping up above the rest of the wax paper. And now what I'm actually going to do is just lay this over top of our acrylic ornament, line everything up. And then once you got it positioned wherever you want it to go onto your surface, you can then just grab a little squeegee tool like this one right here. Burnish that down onto the surface itself. Lift up the rest of the transfer tape with the design. Pull out the wax paper or parchment paper or whatever you're using, and then grab the little squeegee tool and then basically just kind of slide it across your design while you're also just perfectly applying your decal to your surface. This also helps to greatly minimize any air bubbles that may occur as well. All right, so I gotta say, I'm really impressed with this transfer tape so far. Like, it honestly, it really reminds me of the medium tack transfer tape. I mean, it's kind of great. All right, so I'm gonna do the same thing now with this little decal and the wax paper. Just position it onto the wax paper where just a little bit of the actual decal itself is popping up above the rest of the wax paper. All right, so that's positioned where I want it to be. So now I'm gonna go ahead and grab my little squeegee tool and then just burnish that little top part down and then pick up my transfer tape, peel it away from that wax paper, and then just pull that wax paper out from there. And then again with the squeegee, I'm just gonna take that and then just slowly burnish that down onto the surface. And just one last time, once you actually got your decal exactly where you want it to be, go ahead and burnish down the top part of that design. Then go ahead and lift up the rest of the transfer tape, pull out the wax paper or parchment paper, and then just burnish down the rest of it. All right, so now I'm gonna go ahead and peel off the white film on the back of the ornament. And then we'll just go ahead and string some ribbon through this and we'll be done. Now, if you all liked today's video, or if you learned something new, it would honestly mean the world to me if you went ahead and stamped that like button, as well as dropped a comment down in the comment section below. Both of those things help me out tremendously here on YouTube, and I honestly just cannot thank you enough. Also, while you're at it, if you are new around here and you're also just trying to figure out how to use your Cricut cutting machine, well, you may want to consider stamping that subscribe button and then ringing that little bell for all the notifications, because I put out new Cricut tips, tricks, and tutorials every single week, and you do not want to miss out on a single Cricut minute. Again, do not forget about our 12 days of Craftmas. Make sure that you take down all of the little random words that pop up throughout the course of this video, jot them down, and then text them in to me at 502-878-7189. Or if you are outside of the United States, you could always email them to me at mcpgiveaways@gmail.com. Thank you all so, so, so much for watching today's episode. It really does mean the absolute world to me, and I honestly, I cannot thank you enough. And until next time, stay crafty.